St. Luke chapter 15, verses 18 and 19. Pray. And I will rise up and go to my father, and I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy hired servants. Amen.
Amen. Namase ne se eja maye osoro ni wani mbone edun krono na me mfata se wo be frem wo be bio na ye me se wa powerful mu ba kon onyame nshira sume na dumti amen
enyano mamunyina yonkodo
yakunye
enyame ase se eneden so odi ache.
We thank God for giving us today.
Me fakunya isu na mada asafu mu asofo asompeni fo ba sonfo any to prayer minister for any na asi.
I will take this opportunity to give thanks to God first, the pastors, the elders, entire church board, and especially prayer ministries department.
Afi asafu menyina so asidani bi enko emma.
And to the entire congregation, I say a big thank to you.
Ne mpaibone akomchre eda na wotwe nyina.
Today is prayer and fasting day.
Na tifia semeda esuno eye enkanya ene asem no.
The main theme is revival and the word.
Na de odima nyina se ese yenya enkanya ewo ya brabo mu.
The whole issue is to be revived in the word of God.
Nafi yene asem no eye baako eye Christo.
And we should condone and connive with the word which is Christ.
Say ba sorry ye ko ni nyina eye nanso enu enye enu ne enkenya no enkenya no say where you who are free to be afar from.
Coming to church, going back home is enough. It's good. Not enough. The enough and the most revived to be revived is having Christ in you.
Na empire boda maybe ka asem bi a chiro no hutumi a ewo empire bom ni hia hia se yasetre mu no ye man empire bo eye yeduan.
Today is prayer day and I'm going to tell you a story that will let you know the importance of prayer and how often you should pray.
1986 na me call technical school ewo eho.
I was in technical school in 1986.
Na emre na mi hia bibi wo mema me ho e wo achim asia kwa nte free ho e ba asia kwa no e kwan bia emu wa pa.
I needed something from my mom, but from where I'm schooling to my parents area is a long distance.
Ese se me ban so nti fiere numre bi me sre kwan na me sim se me kwa na sabre no so no ye nyira enim na runs mrem no na satam no na kafiu e wo hopa.
And I needed to come desperately, so I set off one Friday evening, and by that time there was a curfew in our in Ghana.
Dodo no ana satam e wo Ghana na na ni efi no ye hu se na na kafiu no de tumi bi enim.
That was a revolution.
Se na tumi wo kafiu mu pa ti bia wo be ko mu no.
That was a revolution day which every law was in order.
Na sabre no so na ka ho den se wo be free ho aba ko fodri anuntumi nyaka e batin agin se ofa no supe supe esisi
and from where I'm schooling to where I have to go, the distance is a long distance, and it's difficult to get transport as well, so you have to change transport.
Anuntimi fabe si kru bi e frɛ hɔ bon e wo e kwa no so hɔ cause e hɔ no o ma efri akosombo o ma efri hɔ hɔ o ma efri hɔ no ye nyina e be hie mu hɔ. Now who drew so I honor now man cockofodia no more call and crown also no omo omatwe mu akọ.
I boarded a car and I have to alight at a village called Pong, and from there I have to take another car to Kofodia where my mom is.
They drew honor and nipa na egu honor na nyasem ketoa obia ho yiran because say free honor ko ba bia kọ no kafio no chi wo kwa mu a o asem asem beto pa bia honor kra kafio no chi wo ho a wo hu kwa be fa
so
a.
So from that point people have crowded because there was no transport, not enough transport. So people are waiting and the curfew time is getting off. I'm just emphasizing to let you know the power of prayers.
na me nyɔ kwan hwɛ no saa tam no na me abremu a mɛsi so bet yɛ titi mu methodis na fie titi mu no ma wo fo nyinaa no mɔ yɛ nipa no mɔ kwa sɔre panti na empire bɔ no na yɛ nim sɛ ne
I wasn't Adventist by then. My parents were Methodist. But it happened to me that I should pray at that moment.
Timekobutu ekwanu chembe bi ehonu ebiaya yeton abodo ni to mabok kios nketengite okwanu timekobusu kios no ba kwachi na me bompa ye bipa na mu odin park ka chire ruade se abamu amesi so si echime oha me nimti bi amekomti onhye ne ho enu nyam.
So I went down behind one of the kiosk and knelt down and prayed. And said, God, I'm just a youth. And if I should be caught in this situation with this curfew, you know what will happen to me.
Then you are no kind of thing to you. I want a car back with CNA, police in EBS here for him. And you know, or see, you're just a little bit madame for no name or the bro for a fee or the coat, you know, will be a teacher because honor not a I be formed, you know, then you're depending on a teacher, you know, so we send me teacher.
So after my prayers, a car arrived and I saw a policeman coming out of the car. And in conversations, he made friends with me.
No tie one car be by the car gina no so on for be a police ni no kwa no be fa no. And unti police ni so e wa police ka je so me ni minya kuma ne nam. Unti so betumi afa no aka me ho an ka me da wasipa. Driver no se
So another car came, and the car said, "I'm not going to pick anybody apart from the policeman."
But
lo and behold, the policeman said, "I'm not walking alone. I'm walking with my little friend. If you are not taking the friend, then it means I'm not going." The driver said, "Okay, I'll pick you and your friend."
So as the police know, so no, driver didn't stop. The police now man at the front. Na kefi no chenwa.
You know the police, the driver take advantage of the police. When you sit him in the front, no stop on the road. And the curfew, you'll be free. So the driver saw that, no, if I leave this guy, the policeman will not go with me. So I have to put both of them.
Ema ye ko efie bi efie kese ye duro na nipa edida apontin won bebre to bi epon na ye wura edem.
So soon as we arrived at Koforidua, the alarm blew for curfew time, and he held my hand and we went to a place, a compound house. There are many people sitting there, so we entered into the house.
Na de chiye no no ankasa som inside betina transport and o twa ticket mame ameleko asia kwa.
And the following morning he brought me to the transport yard, obtained a ticket for me to my mom's place.
Na owura no troni din e ma me samba ho a owo his depo ntimemra me ba me hu no.
And the man wrote his name on a piece of paper for me that I am in hopeless depo. When you come back, come and see me.
You are my mom who took me on pie boom. Now, me, you are my best ne. Me call here, me could be so pure, depot home, so moon, omun in papa.
Beloved, look at the power in prayers. I went back to the and went to the police depot looking for the policeman. Up to now, I never saw that man.
If you are me, Kofodia Yepa, if you are Dimikomono, be the mania career besine, me who fear ebisine.
I know Kofodia very well. But up to now, the house he took me to, I've never located that house. So I'm convinced that the prayers that I'd offered to God, he answered it in that way. Shall we pray?
Mokramo brun bi erade ene de enya dwe sakra matumi emenye fiem de muhamma ye hawo ne amane bi adiba nene ye befri hano ne kunim de ye de wadom ti amen
amen
ore bi tnasi
a man there lived a man
na trust them say not oyo the four pa
bible says he was a rich man
ene ye ka ene pa anka we one of the billionaires
he should have been one of the billionaires at this moment
owon fra o japade e mo bibia ora na obi
he had many servants slaves wealth animals everything he had.
Na trust him say na owo emrant emamienu ye mamu a emienu.
The Bible says he had two children.
Na she obi a oyo de for say wetu say ni man so no onbe yo de for pa. She knew am jiji say ebehia enkola no e ofie ho.
Look at this wealthy man with only two children. I believe they might have been rich by nature.
And na ye de ba abrabom kwa ye hwe ade for ya na ye moma president for moma omo kwa securities. I guide you on cars I can see on them. And you had the 20 million. You say some rent here to be away from and a sabre no not on mobile.
If we compare it today to today, people on authorities have their children, everything for their children. They have protection, they have wealth, they have everything. So that man was a rich man.
Na Bible say when you know, you know, ne ba kitwa no wo no da cross sorry and no catch your papa say. Meja sisi amanyi babia madu me bro dumotwe timi hia me fa ho die.
The Bible say one day the little among the children got up and said, "Dad, I know my right now. I'm grown. I'm over 18."
Die o nyina no tibi o nyina ne ni anso wo ka chiri papa say me japade ehia esese wu a de mama me no ene me nya made na.
He never respected a parent. He never thought of what is going to happen. He said, "Today I am grown, so I need a portion of my share if you should die. Now."
Oba tan odon ba me gidi se odifuto bebre be ma abranti. Obeka chese me ba hweni ma ofia ne nyina ya odia. Dempa ne hia o. Efra na ope, sika na ope, awale na ope ne nyina menye bia ma o.
A loving parent wouldn't just give the things and say, "Go away." He might have sat the child down and advised him, "My son, I'm rich. Everything you need, you get. So please, consider your decision."
Naso abrante fa hundi a ope. So benyani fa hundi enuntino wantie ede ni papa e kachre.
But for freedom's sake, the son understood or listened to the parent.
Enyanu minu mienu ye koya brabo mwa. Si ye bedrin pa ya koti biye bisim da.
Beloved, you and I, if we should think of our situations, we've been in such a situation.
Ya koti biye ye mu bebre wa hanom. Ye nyanu mne kofa e frigana bae. E sa ye fa hundia ye pentino. Ye nyan a thousand bipe ye se ye pe kwa yine yati ye hon.
Many of us, you might have been helped by somebody, a friend or a brother, to come here. But once you've got this little pounds, you say, "Oh, I know my right." Most of us, because of freedom, our marriages are in disaster. For a little thing you might have got, no matter what elders and adults will tell you about your marriage, you say, "No, I'm not going to listen."
Brothers
and sisters, we're going to pray. I know you've been in a situation like that, and it didn't end you well.
Yet to me prefer who dear be no yan shea.
We most at times struggle for freedom, and at the end it doesn't end as well.
Sami pe mi fa hu die, e sami de mi hu na mi kobo mi bra. E bia unya no aduba ye no onim die beto dachi. Nyame nim die beto dachi. Enti de bia o prese ye tran na ase na kunim die ayeye dia.
You might have been looking for your freedom by your brother or your sister who helped you to come here. Or who helped you in this world knows what will happen to you at the end, so he always advises you. But all advice ends up in vain.
My
brother and my sister, you're going to pray for yourself. Thinking of what have happened to you, you might have been through such a situation and it didn't end you well. You're going to tell your God.
And then pay bono obi amobi and penny for say obi numa drum on oyale for a womb, said Obiba Bompai Boom, now so one cassa no nim to be our comb. Sorry, Bompai and it's in Frenya, I say. So what cause that to be a dunya and a day on for Bonnie and Chow?
Today's prayer pattern is going to be pray for yourself. You know what has happened to you, you know what you've gone through. So you're going to stand up and pray to God and tell Him what has happened to you for Him to bring you back.
We're all going
to
stand up.
Pray for yourself that if you have been in a situation like that, may God forgive you and bring you back to track. Prayerfully.
Every most gracious Lord, note in the voice like yours can be so full.
As we conclude our prayers, you can take your seat.
I go to thee.
Amen.
Amen.
Trust him, sir. A jai chen, chefano, no de maniba. Na brantie eboa ne mnema nyina no na osikwanso.
The Bible confirmed that a parent shared the property and gave the son his portion and he packed and went away.
Na kuma mno wonim se wanya japade wanya sika wanya ahodie bebre enntu no wawie ewo na brabom.
In his heart he felt good because he's got the wealth he needs. He's got money, he's rich. So he's on top of the world.
Oh, bibia hia me ti me ko makọ jimani
makọ
me bra san se mi hia me fa ho die.
So I'm going to enjoy because I've got my freedom.
The trust him say abranti esi mu.
The Bible say the sun set off.
No ko wiase e chichichichichi.
He went to the far end of the world. Bibia
ni papa ni ni mami kra no omu hu na chiri kwan.
A place where mom and dad would not even know that my son has traveled up to this place.
San se o hia ni fa ho die.
Because he's in freedom. Beloved, that's how we end up in life. Just for a little property, it could be building, it could be car, it could be anything, you said, oh, I'm done in the world. So it ends you up in pride. I've got my money, I've got my things, I don't need help from anybody, so I'm... No matter what advice comes to us, we don't listen. If there should be a grudge between me and my brother, I said, oh, I am of myself. I journeyed my own way. No matter what elders will say, I'll say no.
ye benya hawo ya waliam esase ye na etu ye kwan enu tifutu obi e de be mae no se tufu no antia ewiye no e de ohaw ene ba so.
But in this world, if you neglect advice, it ends you up somewhere you wouldn't want to.
So wo do hoto ho so no adu hoto japade so na enu nti no de beke bia ho ntia nwanom ewiye no enwien kunum de ema wo.
If you depend on yourself and you neglect other people's advice, you know what will happen to you.
Sabrantie tie futuo no tena ni papa ni mami na asia ka meji di se anka ahoto eye ni de da.
If this prodigal son should have listened to the parents' advice and sat down and thought of it, I think he would never had regretted.
Sie tie nyame ni tena ni na asia ewie no enkumdie beye dia.
If we should listen to God and sit under his feet, at the end glory will be our.
Now so say yes or din ye fa if ye say ye hear fa who de ye hear say ye dear who to a japadia so ye hear say ye dear who are in yanum yan hue and kunidiano obrego and
a if we become disobedient and depend on ourselves and said we need our freedom, the end might not be well.
Now
for
some say a branti koye koye jap oko chine ni.
This guy went and spent till he had nothing anymore.
Na arehosta ma wo mu se obi ano ye odifo obi ano ye skaniba obi ano papa ne ne maame ahundia bebre ewiye no na empreko enana ohwom so.
The most miserable thing is a child from a wealthy family who has everything, access to everything, ended up in looking after pigs.
Me chidi say enkoa won ne maame ne papa fie kura no semo an kura ne bia no mo hwe so because ne e chiwade ma yankopon.
I believe the servant in his father's house wouldn't even have looked after pigs.
Nyanom sane wiase no etie.
That is how the world is.
Say antre nyame ase ne anye siti ma nyame a de wiase re be kwa koduru no afi be bia be koduru no.
If you should not sit under the feet of Christ and take the advice and the counsel of Christianity, it will end up you in a place where you wouldn't like.
So when
if you neglect the advice from the Word of God, from the elders, from the pastors, and even from your church members, at the end, it might not end you well.
Trust him, say Abranti. Empo emo no mpyom suno. E kombe di noama. E diani nu kura o pebi kura. E asine nu kura suno. Na o nyebi.
The Bible say the boy was so wretched that he became hungry and wanted to eat even the food for the pigs, but he wouldn't get it.
Obia no ya difo. Obia woni bi biya. Obia oti fiya. En kwane frechwa nweshiano.
A boy from a wealthy family now starving himself, not even getting food for pigs. We're going to pray here. We've been in this situation. We depend on ourselves. We depend on our properties. We depend on our money. And at the end, it ended up miserably. At the end, because of disobedience to God's word, we've lost all those properties. Think of it. Have you been in such a situation before? Many of us have been.
No matter.
A neglected counseling, depending on yourself, depending on your property, today you might have said, had I known. The little money you had in your pocket has ended up destroying your marriage. The property that you have depended has today separated you from your siblings. If you had listened to advice and counsels, it wouldn't have ended you up in this way. We're going to stand up for two people to pray for us.
Si ya ko 30 pm ye de ho atu agapade so ye de ho atu sika so ye de ho atu ya ho de so na wie no e de akoha obi ma onfam from so no enche.
They're going to communicate to our God on our behalf that if we had in one way or the other depended on ourselves or on our property and that ended us in a negative way, may God forgive us. So two of us are going to stand up and pray for us.
Yefa wiase adwendwen yefa enema ensene mfata edivra akoman mu a entimi enwra sedia shape ne tie ne pepepe enu ntino ebema abroso na fe aye enema ensene mfata ne senti ne yakai ye hunu sa ne yabo wanim no na yeso woni se fe mfum so ne emrato cheye ne fa odo ewra ye nakoma mu na bibia ebe bia no se odo mu a na yeye ade ahye wu twedi ampon kwa mu din konkron na ni monyam ifisi ni mse uyo odo nyame na yeso ni se fiamfonso na emrato cheye se ye bia no ni ye bo udin ese ho boni facha Kristo udin mu facha yenda
amen
okra mu broni bia obebo udin ase ho no made se esu bi kra no pesu oje mu no wo odoba Jesus Christ din mu so bo udin kwa awrade tie ne da mu ye mobo ebra ya bo wani mi mi ye fa ya dadwen ye hawo ye sintone ye mrato en free wani mu ensan fa nko ma ye nsue mu na ase ne ye fa adom enhyira odo ene ehumobro en free wani mu nko wo odoba Jesus Christ din mu ti amen
amen
na trust him say emra brantie ewo fum wo na komo de no na mpo mu anaduane onye bi ni no osina dwe se obesan akọ ne papa ho.
The Bible says as the sun wanders about
let opegene opegene ni
doesn't want to get anything, he casts his mind back and said I have to go back.
O ka se ah o di for the same de ne ni mi papa fie ah me bre o ha se Japan enema bay a enkwane frabe na ni papa fie empo juma me ye omo papa fie kra no omo nye sa juma we.
He came back to his senses and start thinking, what happened to me? Why should a son from a wealthy family do such a job? I'm thinking even the slaves or the servants in my father's house will not work as I'm working here.
Na nyanum de pia me kai sa Luke 15 ya ahai
Beloved, anytime I take this my Bible and look through Luke chapter 15 verses 17 and 18, when I get to this point, I become sad.
Na dia brethren kai se empo mi kona mi papa wanyimia onfa mi se na pamfo no mu emu eba ko.
The boy said, I would definitely surely go back, and even if my dad would not own me as a son, he should consider me as one of his hired servants.
Ano ye difo no ene o prese empo ba ye den obeye akwa.
This is a son from a worthy family now pleading to be a servant.
Obi ano oja padie sika e cars enkoa ene Oma bon ho ban no ene o prempo se obeye akwa esan tibia
a young boy who was worthy by nature, who was rich, now pleading to be a servant.
Esan futu a wanti enti
just because of neglecting counsel.
Esan ni fa ho dia no openti no
just because of independence.
Ene o prese empo obeye akwa,
now he's pleading to be a servant.
Enyanom sanity yanhweye a obra hebrei e wo nyame fie ha akukuria sa ye bro nyame fie ha no yanhwe ya dabi beba no empo akwa kra pe sa ye nyame fie no yanhwe ya na aboye.
Beloved, so it should be, it may be that the toils, trials and the suffering you going through in the house of the Lord, a time may come you might plead to be even a servant.
Mre bi beba empo na wo be pe sa asor dem akra no utu na si ha nanso na akachi.
A time will soon come, you might wish you can even step your foot into the chapel, but that time will be gone.
Na energy same o woman say oba tan a odo ne ba nyame na ni ku ye ho nyame a odo ye no bia e be ko bia no nenu edaso edi echi.
The happiest thing is that a loving parent, no matter where the child wanders to, the eyes and the mind still follows the son. No matter what situations we've gone through, he will still not deny us or neglect us. He's still following us.
Trust him, say. Abrantie, emra okoye nyina no ne papa wa nada de bia osori a ogira na ban na ban tintin so no hwe chirichiri say obehu ne ba no.
The Bible says after this son left home that never slept, always on of a building, looking afar to see if he can see the sun coming back home.
And until Emran, a brandy, a sea, Najus or Bacono, and it is someone saying, Minyanum, we did a stamina brandy, a gin and you know, no, and Namfo or Namfa no, no, Bosa, a cohibrano. Now, so see Najay Pino, we just said one Cobana Danfubia Amania.
I believe the sun, when he went out, he had friends, he made friends who were enjoying together. But when a time came for him to think of himself, he never even bothered to inform any of his
I believe
he has purpose in his heart that I must go back home. So he thought, if I go and inform any of these friends who are enjoying, they will give me a polluted mind. Say, what do you think of your dad? My friend, forget about him and let's enjoy here.
Beloved,
Beloved, if it might happen to you that you've been in such a situation and a time come for you to think of yourself, don't involve your friends. They might give you the polluted mind and say, oh, forget about it. If there's a revival in your life, just take a step and follow it. Do not consider how sinful you are. God is faithful and he's just and he's loving, that wherever, whenever you come back, he will accept.
See what dream piece me nua boni ami wo mi me sakrama dwin ne me nyen kan ya foforo na makome urane nchen na makostato bra foforo wa ye krado so obeje wo.
If you purpose in your heart that wherever I have been to, I'm now going back, I'm revived, God is ready to accept you. There's no sin that God cannot forgive unless you did not give way. No matter what life, no matter what sin, if you purpose in your heart that you will change your mind, God is ready to accept
you.
So the Bible says the bird boy purposed in his heart and he was going back, and the father, who was a loving parent, standing saw his son coming from afar and ran and met him on his way. The Bible says if one soul repents from its iniquity, the whole heaven host rejoice.
Then so if you plan of changing
your mind from the evil way you're passing, you're going through, God and his angels are ready to accept you.
Now trust him, say, and you be fee, or run no catch and qua say, maybe oh yeah, no yane, or yra no a sayamba, and untimuma any. Oh, Jaya, now I drop you. Now I drop. If so, Jaya, I was
the moon coming on the sorry. The Bible says, when the father saw his son, he said, happiness has come back home. My son was dead, and he's lost, and he's found. So please let us enjoy. So they slaughtered the fattest sheep among them and made a party for the son.
Na abrante no kachere papa se meja maye bone etia osoro ene asase wankasa waye bone etia nipa o oso waye bone etia osoro ene
meja. And the boy opened his mouth and said, dad, I've sinned against heaven and earth.
Sempo sa unyemi a ene dai famiye o se onfran mo ebu baako.
And if you are not ready to accept me as your son, I'm ready to be called one of your hired servants.
Beloved,
if you sin, don't think you are sinning against your brother.
You are sinning against God.
The happy thing is the dad opened his arms and accepted his son.
And what you said,
it's not too late. Don't say, for how far I've wandered, why would God accept me back?
And what you said, Bonia Maye, Conconsa Medius, Assisu, Cronua Maboy, Jamai Maboy, Eridia Medi, Baden, Eradia Jimmy, or so I hear crowd say, Debiera Besakaraji, now Benyan Kenya or Brabomno, or Bajua.
Don't think of the backbiting, don't think of the stealing, don't think of the whatever you have done, but God is ready to accept you if you purpose to come back.
Catch yourself.
God is calling you, my son, come back
home.
Wherever you have been to, come back home. Don't look at what you've spent out there, come back home. And if you come, you will receive happiness. May God help us. Be merciful unto us. Give us a reviving spirit in our new life. Wherever we've been to, that we may come back home. He is ready to accept us. Amen.
Ni efa mahut Last stanza.
Metu enyo nyam jose, mi wuri se Yesu moja. Eyinti ma yeyini, mi wuri se Yesu moja. Moja e wami,
Ne die ye no o dia mai ne dia boye bra ye se se empo ne de ye be free ha no o kra bi anya dwun sakra boye ne ya bra bom be bia kodu bia no ye san ye chi emra onjen na opa ha beto se fata e de sum ne pa bo jumedi aka nyina hye wosa boye ne ne de bi bia ye be ye no nye de di o chi e be bra wadunti amen.